फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद पार्ट टू ऑफ क्लास 10 ज्योग्राफी चैप्टर 2 फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ रिसोर्सेज. सो इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी अंडरस्टूड दैट आर फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ आर इन अ वेरी ग्रेट डेंजर एंड आर डिप्लीटिंग एट अ वेरी रैपिड रेट. सो द सोल्यूशन टू दिस प्रॉब्लम इज कंजर्वेशन ऑफ फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. नाउ लेट अस स्टडी अबाउट दिस कंजर्वेशन ऑफ फॉरेस्ट एंड वाइल्ड लाइफ. So now, why is conservation needed? Why should we bother about conservation of plants and animals? And the answer is that conservation preserves our ecological diversity and our life support systems such as air, water and soil. Second, it preserves the genetic diversity of plants and animals for their better growth and breeding. So now let us study the steps taken by Indian government towards conservation of forests and wildlife. First, the Indian Wildlife Protection Act was implemented in 1972. Now let us study the salient features of Indian Wildlife Protection Act. First, it made provisions for habitat protection of forests and wildlife. Second, an All India list of protected species was published by the government. Third, protecting remaining population of endangered species by banning hunting and giving legal protection to habitats of these species. Fourth, restricting trade in wildlife. So the buying and selling of wildlife, of wild animals or their body parts such as claws, horns, etc. was banned by the government. And fifth, setting up of national parks and sanctuaries. So various sanctuaries and wildlife parks and national parks were set up by the government in various parts of the country. The second step taken by the government is that the central government has announced several projects for the protection of specific animals which are gravely threatened. For example, tiger, one-horned rhinoceros, Kashmir stag, freshwater and saltwater crocodiles, gharial, asiatic lion, etc. We shall learn about Project Tiger in the next section. Third, recently the Great Indian Elephant, Black Buck, Great Indian Bustard, Snow Leopard, etc. have also been given legal protection. Fourth, in the notification under Wildlife Act of 1980 and 1986, several hundred butterflies, moths, beetles, dragonflies, etc. have been added to the list of protected species. So now even insects are being given legal protection. Fifth, in 1991, six species of plants were also added to this list. So now even plants are also being given protection. So now let us study about one such important conservational project, which is the Project Tiger. So the tiger population had reduced from 55,000 to just 1,827 between 1900 to 1973. And the tiger population was on the verge of extinction. So due to this, in 1973, the Project Tiger was launched. And its aim was to protect and expand tiger population by conservation methods. And in this project, many tiger reserves were set up in India. And few examples are Sundarban Reserve, Jim Corbett National Park, and Sarishka Wildlife Sanctuary. So with this, we come to the second topic of this video, that is types and distribution of forests and wildlife. So in India, much of the forest and wildlife resources are managed by the government through forest department. And there are three categories of forests that are reserved forests, protected forests and unclassed forests. Now we shall learn about all these categories one by one. First, reserved forests. So more than 50% of the total forests have been declared as reserved. These are more valuable for conservation of forests and wildlife. So in these forests, human activity is not allowed, and these forests are mainly for conservation of forest and wildlife. These forests are majorly found in Jammu Kashmir, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal, Uttarakhand, etc. Second, protected forests. So 1/3 of the total forest area in India is protected forest, and these are protected from any further depletion. And these are found in Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Bihar, and Odisha. So both reserved and protected forests are collectively known as permanent forests, and these are used for producing timber, protection of wildlife, etc. And Madhya Pradesh is the state with largest forest area under permanent forest. The third type of forest is unclassed forest, and these are the forests and wastelands belonging to both government and local communities or private individuals. So these forests are owned by the local communities or even by a private individual, and these are found in the urban areas. And they are mostly found in the states such as Northeast, Gujarat, etc. Other states also have these forests, but in these states which I have mentioned, they are in large quantity. So till now, I have only told you about the steps taken by the government towards conservation of forests and wildlife. But apart from the government, the community as a whole also has taken various steps for conservation of forests and wildlife. Let us study these. First, inhabitants of 5 villages in Alwar district of Rajasthan have declared their own rules which don't allow hunting and encroachment in the forests. Second, Indian societies comprise several cultures, each has its own traditional methods of nature conservation. Sacred qualities are often attributed to springs, plants, animals, etc. These are closely protected by the people. For example, you must have observed that in the temples, people or banyan trees are considered sacred and people worship them. Similarly, we find monkeys, langurs, macaques, etc. near temples and nobody hurts them. So this is a way for conservation of forest and wildlife. Third, the famous Chipko movement in the Himalayas has successfully resisted deforestation. Fourth, the joint forest management is another good example in which the local communities are involved for the management and restoration of forests. Fifth, Beech Bachao Andolan and Navdanya have shown that crops can be produced without any synthetic chemicals. So with this, we come to the end of this chapter. Thank you.